आप लोग वहाँ कर लें तो शुरू करें हम लोग, बिकॉज आज डीब्रीफिंग नहीं होगी क्योंकि ये हॉल चाहिए किसी को। आज डीब्रीफिंग नहीं हो पाएगी क्योंकि हॉल आप कमरे में ट्राई कर सकते हैं, तो यहाँ पर कोई मीटिंग हो रही है इस कमरे में। हाँ वहाँ कर टू वेकेट दिस रूम आफ्टर सम टाइम। शुरू करें वहाँ पर। आप कर दीजिए आगे, यहाँ से कर दीजिए। दो चैनल्स गिर गए। ठीक है जो भी है लेट्स स्टार्ट नाउ। शुरू कर दो बिना डिस्क्रिमिनेशन के, सब चैनल्स को बराबर गिरा दिया गया है। अच्छा अब शुरू करें मित्रों। फ्रेंड्स पीपल कैन लाई एंड डिस्टॉर्ट बट फैक्ट्स कैनॉट बी इग्नोर्ड। ऑब्जेक्टिव फिगर्स एंड फैक्ट्स इनडिस्प्यूटेबली एस्टैब्लिश दैट देयर इज वन सुप्रीम आयरनी फ्रॉम विच द बीजेपी एंड मिस्टर मोदी आर ऑलवेज रनिंग अवे। The irony is that the competition on good governance based on facts is only between UPA 1 and UPA 2. It is not between NDA and UPA 1 and not between NDA and UPA 2. And I will demonstrate this to you from facts. My senior colleague did so yesterday with a similar but a different set of facts, and that is why you have to ask yourself the question. That rhetoric, polemics, slogans, supposed oratory skills, or as we are now told, the lack of oratory skills, cannot make up for facts and figures. It is a very interesting irony, as I said, that the competition, if at all, is between NDA and UPA 1, is not between NDA and UPA 1, but only between UPA 1 and UPA 2. And I am going to demonstrate it. These facts I have given to you partly before. I have shared with your colleagues in Bangalore and Mumbai. I am sharing with you in a little more detail in continuation of the facts and figures given yesterday by my senior colleague. Let us take NDA 6 years. Let us take UPA 1 5 years. Let us take UPA 2 4 years. There is no trickery here. The years are known. I am taking 6, 5 and 4. And we have also got a similar chart on this which the AICC has, which you can collect later on. Let us take 5, 10, 12 major indicators for 6 years NDA, 5 years UPA 1, 4 years UPA 2. This is informed debate. This is real debate. It is not confusing you. It is not running away with facts. On growth of GDP percent per year, 6.0, 8.4, 7.3. That is 6.0 NDA, 8.4 UPA 1, 7.3 UPA 2. This is average annual percentage GDP growth in this country. What does it show, friends? Our lowest average annual, let me tell you, if you add the last year, which has been not so good, certainly we accept, it is even then close to 6.4. But we have official figures of Planning Commission only till 6, 5 and 4 years. It shows that our lowest, worst average rate of growth per year is higher than the NDA's highest, best. Competition number 2, agricultural growth. There are 3 major things in the economy: agricultural growth, manufacturing growth, services growth. Let us look at all 3. Same, NDA, UPA 1, UPA 2, 6, 5 and 4. Agricultural growth is 2.9, 3.1 and 3.6. This, by the way, is one area where UPA 2 has outdone UPA 1. Although I am frank enough to admit that on many parameters, UPA 2 has been slightly behind UPA 1 also. But always ahead of NDA. So agricultural growth is 2.9 NDA, 3.1 UPA 1 and 3.6 UPA 2. Industrial growth, 5.5, 9.2 in UPA 1 and 6.0 in UPA 2. Services growth, NDA did well, they did 7.8. UPA 1 did 9.9 and UPA 2 did 8.9. Repeat, remember, 2 points. Competition only between UPA 1 and UPA 2, NDA nowhere in the picture, and lowest of UPA 9 years average is better than the highest of NDA 6 years. Poverty reduction is very interesting. इस देश में सबसे महत्वपूर्ण मुद्दा है अगर है कि गरीबी रेखा से किसको कैसे कम किया गया, और हम सबके लिए बराबर है गरीबी रेखा. आप इस विवाद में न पड़े कि कौन सी रेखा सही है, कौन सी रेखा गलत है, कोई एक मापदंड होना आवश्यक होता है. गरीबी को कम करने, करोड़ों को गरीबी रेखा से ऊपर लाने में एक दशक है, 93-94 से लेके 03-04, एक दशक हुआ 10 साल, इसमें एनडीए के 6 साल शामिल हैं. 0.74% ओनली, यानी 3/4 से कम, 1% का, 0.75 से कम. उसका अगला दशक 04-05 से 11-12 दशक से थोड़ा सा कम है, 2.18%, 3 गुना ज्यादा. यूपीए 1 प्लस यूपीए 2 को मिला लीजिए तो 3 गुना ज्यादा पॉवर्टी रिडक्शन है कंपेयर टू एनडीए. 3 गुना का मतलब होता है मित्रों, करोड़ों लोग ज्यादा गरीबी रेखा से ऊपर उठाए हमने, अगर तुलनात्मक रूप से देखें हम एनडीए के साथ. औसतन फिस्कल डेफिसिट 5.5 इन एनडीए, यूपीए 1 डिड नॉट डू सो वेल, दिस इज द ओनली एरिया वेर यूपीए 1 डिड लेस देन एनडीए, 3.9. But UPA 2 outdid UPA 1 and did equal to NDA, 5.5 again. So average fiscal deficit is 5.5, 3.9 and 5.5. Now two very good indicators which for the earlier years, Mr. Chidambaram told you yesterday. I am giving you a direct comparison of NDA, UPA 1 and UPA 2. Do mahatvapurna mapdand hote hain, savings rate ausatan aur investment rate ausatan. Savings rate 25.4%, pretty good by the NDA, average annual. UPA 1 33.9, extraordinary. And UPA 2 32.2, much better than NDA. Investment rate, not bad by the NDA, 25.2, high figures. UPA 1 35.2%. 10% more than NDA, and UPA 2 outdid UPA 1 36.1%. ये कोई आम आंकड़े नहीं है, ये महत्वपूर्ण, अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण चौंकाने वाले आंकड़े हैं। कौन बात कर रहा है सुशासन की, कौन बात कर रहा है आर्थिक विकास की, कौन बात कर रहा है विकास की? अगर ये बातें करनी है तो रैलियों में बड़े बड़े शब्दों को यूज करके, दूसरों पे गालियां देकर, टॉन्ट करके, मजाक उड़ा के, इन आंकड़ों से आप दूर नहीं भाग सकते। और चाहे प्रेस के कुछ हिस्सों में ये बोरिंग लगे, पर्याप्त रूप से रिपोर्ट ना हो, आपके इंटरेस्ट को होल्ड ना करें, लेकिन मैं इन आंकड़ों के आधार पर बोलने से नहीं झिझकूंगा, क्योंकि वास्तविक धरातल ये है। टू वेरी एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी फिगर्स आई वांट टू गिव यू, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। वन इज हाउ मच इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यू जनरेट, द अदर इज हाउ मच कैपेसिटी यू एड। नाउ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन इज मेजर्ड इन बिलियन, बी फॉर बॉम्बे, बिलियन के डब्ल्यू एच। एनडीए डिड इन 2004-05 इन वन ईयर व्हेन दे लेफ्ट, इनफैक्ट जस्ट आफ्टर दे लेफ्ट, द हाईएस्ट पीक फ्रॉम प्रीवियस ईयर, 587 बिलियन किलोवाट्स। यूपीए वन इन 2008-2009 व्हेन दे लेफ्ट, 724 बिलियन, दैट इज ऑलमोस्ट 33% मोर देन एनडीए। यूपीए टू लास्ट ईयर 12-13, लास्ट ईयर के फिगर्स अवेलेबल हैं, 912 बिलियन किलोवाट्स, करीब करीब दुगुना इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन, करीब करीब दुगुना, करीब 80% ज्यादा। एडिशन टू जनरेशन कैपेसिटी, भविष्य के लिए कितना आपने बिजली दिया है, कैपेसिटी कितनी ऐड की है, एनडीए 3805 मेगावाट्स, यूपीए 15398, 33% ज्यादा। और अगर आप यूपीए 2 का फिगर सुनेंगे तो चौंक जाएंगे, 5 गुना ज्यादा, 15717 मेगावाट, 3805 मेगावाट यूपी एनडीए एंड 15717 मेगावाट यूपीए 2। आई हैव कोल प्रोडक्शन फॉर यू, आई हैव सीमेंट प्रोडक्शन फॉर यू, आई हैव फूड ग्रेड प्रोडक्शन फॉर यू। आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू गिव यू द फिगर्स बिकॉज यू विल से दैट आई एम इनंडेटिंग यू विद फिगर्स, दे आर अवेलेबल। In each, the UPA 1 has done better than NDA by 15-20%, UPA 2 has done better than NDA by 25-33%. And I'm talking of coal production, cement production, food grade production. The question you have to ask yourselves, friends, is this a reality in the form of a house of cards? Is this a ivory tower being created for you? What is this absolute victory announcement before the race has begun? What is this constant taunt on learning governance from some mythical person who says that he knows all about governance and that the whole world knows nothing? We have walked the talk, we have bitten the bullet, we have put our money where our mouth is. We are talking of demonstrated, achieved 9 years. The first time any government after Prime Minister Nehru has shown 10 years. Figures are for 9 years. So if you can show an average over 10 years, 2 terms, what and who has the right in this country to talk of good governance? And who will get the prize for fooling the people or trying to fool the people with slogans, shibboleths and big words every time? Mind you, friends, this is totally apart from the figures given yesterday by my colleague at this very podium. That chart you have, that chart also I have. And that chart tells you that 0708, which was the chart given to you yesterday with yellow marking, if you remember, has extraordinary figures of achievement. I am not repeating it. Fiscal deficit, revenue deficit, total plan expenditure, foreign exchange reserves. Very interesting. Which is now over 300, it touched 310 or 309.7 in that year. Net FDI, net FII, exports. I am not repeating because yesterday you have the chart in writing. Compare 07 and 08 with 13-14. Let's take a bad comparison because last 1.5 years are admittedly not so good. even then you have the figures of yesterday. Far, far, far better than 2002, 2003, which you also have. Far better than 0304, which you also have only yesterday. And far better than 98, 99, which you also have. Now, these are 10 other parameters. Some are overlapping with my figures, but 80% are different parameters. So, what in a nutshell is happening? In a nutshell, somebody is trying to fool this country. And if this country has achieved this growth, this is where it hits you, this is where it hurts you, this is where it benefits you, this is where it comes back to you in real daily life, then I think everybody knows whom we should have as the next government. Thank you. हमने उनको पूरी छूट दे दी है, हमने पूरी छूट दे दी है हर प्रकार से कि देश के किसी भी भाग में, किसी भी जगह जितना भी मिथ्या प्रचार करना चाहते हैं, जब भी करना चाहते हैं, जितनी बार भी करना चाहते हैं, करें। न कोई प्रतिबंध है, सिर्फ उनकी क्रेडिबिलिटी का प्रतिबंध है। और जो जनता सुनती है और जानती है कि मिथ्या प्रचार है, अगर उनके साथियों द्वारा प्रोवाइडेड बड़े बड़े जहाज टाइम पर लैंड नहीं करते हैं, तो कृपया हमें दोषी न ठहराएं। मैं नहीं समझता कि आप सीरियसली मुझे अपेक्षा करते हैं कि ऐसी चीज़ में टिप्पणी करूंगा। ए और बी की वार्तालाप में मेरे से टिप्पणी क्यों पूछ रहे हैं आप? उद्धव ठाकरे जी से पूछिए। मैं नहीं समझता कि इस प्रकार की टिप्पणी में कोई भी व्यक्ति को किसी प्रकार की टिप्पणी करने की आवश्यकता है। निश्चित रूप से मिथ्या प्रचार है, निश्चित रूप से चुनाव के वक्त लोग इस प्रकार की चीज़ कहते हैं। क्या आप समझते हैं कि इस पोडियम से इन चीज़ों को डिग्निफाई करना चाहिए या उनको आदर सत्कार देना चाहिए? आई एम रविशिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कॉमेंट बाय मिस्टर ठाकरे, नॉट बाय मिस्टर शरद पवार। आई एम सेइंग दैट दिस काइंड ऑफ कॉमेंट्स यू हैव टू आइदर गो एंड आस्क मिस्टर उद्धव ठाकरे और यू हैव टू रविश देम एंड इग्नोर देम, बिकॉज दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स कैन बी सेड बाय एनीबडी अबाउट एनीबडी। I compliment and salute your imagination, but let me tell you, the BJP has searched hard and long for what they think would be putting up a strong candidate. It's a different matter that no candidate in this country can be strong enough to achieve what they think, and therefore you are finding this result. I think when the actual figures of the voting come, you will find even a more shameful situation as far as the BJP is concerned. And please rest assured that on Varanasi we'll revert to you very shortly, because the whole time is being consumed in finding the most appropriate, and appropriate means appropriate in every which way. And you can rest assured that there is no question of any of the imaginations which you are harboring. Well, as far as your question is concerned, I can say that having given you the main manifesto on the lawns here, you should expect that also very soon. It will only be a further detailing, but you have our complete program, our complete policy, our complete detailing. But apart from asking for your patience for a few days on the subsets of it, since you have asked the question, I must and I cannot hesitate to add that the BJP follows the Congress in the very few good things which the BJP does. The few good things they do, they only follow the Congress. And imitation is the best form of flattery. And we are waiting how much belatedly they will follow with their manifesto. You are asking me a question about my sub-manifesto. I have answered that. I am also asking you a question, or through you answering your question, that I hope that we have the BJP's manifesto a day or two before the actual polling. And I also hope that the votes they are seeking for the last 1 month, which are obviously votes being sought without a manifesto, without a program or a policy, will not be disowned or jettisoned by them on the ground that the manifesto came only now. I have yet to see a seeking of votes and last dates for filing candidates expiring in many areas and still no manifesto. That is because they may want to find it hard to try and give replies to our manifesto, and they will be only trying for that, or because they have no manifesto to propose. मेरी इसमें क्या प्रतिक्रिया होगी, मैं तो यहाँ तक कहूँगा कि अगर कांग्रेस ही भी ऐसा कहते कि बोगस वोटिंग करो तो हम उसका पूरा खंडन करते पुरजोर रूप से। अगर इस देश में कोई भी गणतांत्रिक सिस्टम में भाग ले रहा है और इसमें विश्वास करता है और ऐसी टिप्पणी करता है तो इस मैंने सुनी नहीं है, मैं जानता नहीं उसके बारे में, लेकिन अगर आप जो कह रहे हैं सही है तो निश्चित रूप से इसका व्यापक रूप से कड़े शब्दों में गंभीर रूप से खंडन करना चाहिए। You know, this is a very detailed question and we cannot answer it very briefly, but let me give you a very brief thing. It was a press conference and I can't explain to you. 1 minute. Let me answer the question first. Two or three facts. The report you are talking about in a leading newspaper on page one today is for 1 or 2 years only and regarding a particular subcategory, diploma holders or degree holders. So it's a limited report. And let me tell you, for employment, the work is never complete. We have to move. It's a process, work in progress every day. And certainly we are the first to accept that much more should be and can be done. But let me tell you two or three things. No government has done as much for employment, or the converse, unemployment, to reduce it as the Congress UPA-led government. In unorganized sector, where employment levels were very high, 88%, 10% reduction is there, namely that less from 88, only 78% are now employed in the unorganized sector. That means in economics that when employment in unorganized sector goes down, the organized sector employment has risen. Number two, the rate of unemployment has come down significantly in the UPA 1 plus UPA time. I'll give you the exact figures in a minute. Number three is very important. It's the quality of employment which you have to remember, and I'll end on that. And this really calls for a larger debate, but you should know this. Because of the policies of the UPA, RTE, education, a large number of children who were counted as the employed are now off the employment rolls and are back to school. Gross enrollment ratio has become 116%, more than 100%. The result is that what you think of as unemployment is two things. One, children going back to school where they belong. Second, a large number of persons, males, who had left villages, coming back because of MNREGA. And let me tell you, 5 crore families of MNREGA are not counted as regular employment because they are 3 months, but there are 5 crore there. So both the quality and the quantity and the nature and profile of employment has actually improved considerably with the NDA. But of course, with the UPA. But I am prepared to accept immediately that it's a road which we have to travel more on. But
क्या प्रतिक्रिया ऐसे में जब आपके उपाध्यक्ष ने कहा था कि देश में एक
हमने पहले वक्तव्य दे दिया है, ये तो कानूनी प्रक्रिया है, इस पे हमारी कोई राजनीतिक पार्टी की हैसियत से कोई प्रतिक्रिया नहीं है, हमारा स्टैंड वही है। ये तो एक कानूनी प्रक्रिया है, जो ऑर्डर ऑलरेडी पास हो गया उच्चतम न्यायालय का, उसका रिव्यू हुआ है। आप जानते हैं रिव्यू में सुनवाई नहीं होती है, रिव्यू एक चेंबर में काम होता है और स्टैटिस्टिक्स के आधार पर 99.99% रिव्यू पिटिशन खारिज की जाती हैं। तो ये तो एक कानूनी प्रक्रिया, इस पर कोई टिप्पणी करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है। नो, दैट्स अ टोटली डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन। प्लीज, द रिव्यू पिटिशन एंड द ओरिजिनल पिटिशन इज अबाउट द कम्यूटेशन इशू। यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ तमिलनाडु गवर्नमेंट वेयर द इशू इज नॉट कम्यूटेशन, इट इज रिलीज on supposed parole or whatever else you call. We have made, the government of India has made, and the Congress endorses the government of India stand, that commutation from death to life is one thing and release is a totally different thing. Commutation is something else, that's a different debate. You may have two views on it and we have a view on it. But release on parole for people who are involved in terrorism with central acts, apart from state acts applying, is certainly not possible without involving the central government, and this submission has been made in the Supreme Court. I have read the report. I have already answered this question fully in respect to the previous question asked by your colleague. I have nothing to add to that except to repeat. This is never a done deed. It is always a work in progress. But on the basis of statistics given to you, both in quantity and in profile and quality of employment, no government has done more than the 9 years of UPA rule, both for rural employment, both for retention rate of children and women, both for the return of males to rural households, and also in reducing the rate of unemployment. Bole. Jaldi. ये कौन सा वाला स्टेटमेंट वक्तव्य, आप किस अमेरिकन प्रेसिडेंट या किस अमेरिकन एम्बेसडर के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं जो ऐसी शिफ्ट विदेश नीति में बता रहे हैं? ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है। ऐसा हमको अमेरिकन फॉरेन पॉलिसी लाइक इंडियन फॉरेन पॉलिसी और द फॉरेन पॉलिसी ऑफ एनी डेवलप्ड और डेवलपिंग और स्ट्रांग नेशन डजंट चेंज लाइक द वेदर वेन एवरी डे और एवरी हाफ एन आवर। I think this is something too well known in the ethos of this country. Mr. Modi is judged not only by an event which happened, which is despicable, and both the events are despicable, if I may say so, but what he did or did not do in the aftermath of the incident. And all of you know too well for me to repeat from this podium that there was nothing resembling the Godhra riots for 3 full days after that carnage. There was nothing after the report of the collector to do a cremation in the hometowns and the home villages. You also know the dates when the bodies were kept on public display in Ahmedabad and a certain situation was allowed to develop. Mr. Modi for the last 12 years has never forget explaining that hiatus of 3 days, forget explaining what happened in 3 or 4 other areas after that, has never even fielded questions on this subject. Occasionally he has, when he has run away from the interview. Or, as day before yesterday we saw, he has done the softest of pre-censored interviews. Let him answer to the nation. Let him make a statement reflecting the skeleton of an apology. Forget apology. And then let him ask this question which you are asking. Well, certainly statements are made in the context, and we certainly hold on to a successful UPA3, Congress-led UPA3 scenario. We certainly believe that the only entity which can hold the diverse elements of this country in a harmonious developing mold is this. But the actual contours and composition of that will have to be decided after the elections. और मैं ये हिंदी में स्पष्ट कर दूं कि 2002 की जो वारदात है वो पूरा विश्व इतने अच्छे रूप से जानता है कि उसमें श्री मोदी की टिप्पणी पे टिप्पणी करने की कोई आवश्यकता नहीं है। अगर श्री मोदी में इतनी हिम्मत होती कि वे देश के सामने जवाबदेही देते, एक प्राइवेट इंटरव्यू में इसके बारे में बोलते कि उस घिनौनी वारदात के 3 दिन बाद तक कोई भी रायट्स गोधरा में नहीं हुए थे, और क्यों कलेक्टर के सुझाव को नकारा गया कि जो शव थे उनको क्रिमेट किया जाए गांवों में, क्यों वो शवों को लाया गया अहमदाबाद में, और किस प्रकार से अगले कई दिनों तक एक सिचुएशन को बढ़ने दिया गया, मैं समझता हूं इसके बारे में उनके पास कोई जवाब नहीं है। और जो जवाब दिया उन्होंने एक बार एक इंटरव्यू में, तो उस इंटरव्यू को छोड़ के भाग गए, और या वो जवाब देते हैं एक नोरा कुश्ती वाले इंटरव्यू जो कि परसों उन्होंने दिखाया है। हमने उस दिन उसी दिन ऐसे किसी प्रचार का खंडन किया था, लेकिन हमारे खंडन के कुछ ही घंटों बाद स्वयं श्री पवार ने पूर्ण रूप से खंडन ही नहीं किया उसका, बट एक माफी मांगी चुनाव आयोग से। क्या नरेंद्र भाटी ने किया ये? जब ये हो जाए तब मैं से पूछिएगा। Well, I am not on the jingle. Each person is entitled to have his own jingle. But all that I am concerned about is that jingle or no jingle, there is only one dictatorial, autocratic, self-serving imagery. And a lot of BJP people, not Congress, believe that the beginning of the end of the BJP is matching with the supposed existence of only one person in the BJP. Whether you call it jingle or not, it's up to you, but that's supposed to be the fact of the situation, and obviously it doesn't require rocket science that this is extremely bad for democracy. BJP is not confused. BJP is deliberately hypocritical. It is deliberately trained in speaking in multiple voices and doing double speak to fool the nation. And let me give you a very quick small example. When the BJP came on its only time in power in any reasonable sense from 98 or 99 onwards, it first thing it did was to officially put the so-called Ram Mandir and other issues on the back burner. They remember these issues every year at election time, every 5 years at election time. They remember it when they have to go and get votes, and they forget it when they are supposed to be doing something about it. and this applies to articles 370 or uniform civil code. When we speak of something, we mean what we say and we say what we mean. The BJP is mired in double speak and hypocrisy. ये पहले भी हुआ है और मैं समझता हूं कि ये उनका निर्णय होता है अल्टीमेटली. राजनीति में प्रादेशिक या राष्ट्रीय स्तर पे कोई किसी पार्टी की धौंस के आधार पे ये नहीं करता है, कोई किसी पार्टी के अनुरोध के आधार पे भी नहीं करता है. हर तरफ से लोग सोच समझ